guys, my name is Vidhi Kalra Balana and welcome back to my channel 5 Minute Economics, where I teach economic concepts in a span of just 5 minutes. Well, the topic for today's video is Bertrand's model of oligopoly, as promised to you in my last video, which was the Cournot model of oligopoly and the Stackelberg model of oligopoly. So I have told you in the last video itself that this is the last model and I'll be coming with it very soon. So I am here guys, and in this video I'll be talking all you need to know about this model with the assumptions, diagrams and some very interesting examples. Also in the end I'll be doing a short difference between the three types of models. So yeah, let's get started. Also guys, don't forget to like this video and do subscribe to my channel in case you haven't already, and please do follow me on Instagram on my handle 5 Minute Economics. So guys, the Bertrand's model oligopoly was given by Joseph Bertrand in 1883. Yes, that older model it is, and here now we are in 2024 and starting it. So basically guys, I've already explained to you the Stackelberg and the Cournot's model. In case you haven't watched it, please watch out the links in the description below. So in Cournot's model, we studied that the firms compete against quantity, whereas in Stackelberg's model, we studied that basically they have first mover advantage. But here in the model of Bertrand, we study that firms compete using price. Okay, so both the firms, if you're taking two firms, they, like example, they try to lower the price so as to capture the market. And we as consumers, whoever's giving it at a lower price, we will just get attracted to that firm, isn't it? So that is what the aim is, to compete using price. Consumers obviously want to buy everything at the lowest price. So who gives the lowest gets the market share. And in case the price is same, then the demand is equally split between the two firms. So basically, the firm's aim is to maximize its own profits. So moving ahead quickly to the assumptions, we know all models are incomplete without assumptions. So here's the assumptions, guys. Number one, both the firms, if you're taking two firms, they are producing homogeneous goods. So basically, it's the price war which is going on between the firms, because the products which they are selling are identical. Then there are two or three firms only dominant in the market, and such kind of a model which is known as oligopoly. That's why, you know, Bertrand's model of oligopoly. I've already made a video on oligopoly. Haven't you watched it? Then please check out the link in the description below. They both have complete knowledge about the markets. Of course, they both are known about that. There is no capacity constraint. Basically, it means that they can produce how many goods they want. You know, there is no capacity constraint. As much quantity as they like, they can produce. They are rational. Of course, their aim is to maximize profits, as I just mentioned before also. The decisions are made simultaneously, and they think other firms' price is constant and given. This is very important. Why do they think so? We don't know. But this is an assumption which we have to take, that they think, okay, even if I lower the price, the other firm's going to keep the same price. So this is a stupid assumption, because if they're in the market, both will keep on lowering the price. And lastly, of course, there's no cooperation between the firms. So now coming to the crux of this very model, guys. So there are two strategies which firms can follow. Number one is the price competition strategy, where each firm independently chooses their price and they assume that the other firm's price remains constant. Hum apna rakhenge, dusra ka same hi rahega. Whatever, if we keep our own price, they assume that other ones has keeping the price constant. Or they can take a profit maximization aim, that is, they set the price that maximizes the difference between TR and TC. What is TR? Total revenue. TC is total cost. So the revenue or cost ka difference maximum hoga, then we as a company will get the maximum profit. So these are the two strategies. Now I'll tell you an example. Uske baad you'll be very clear with this concept, guys. So let us assume a telecommunication market where we know we have Jio, Airtel, BSNL, Vodafone, Idea, 3-4 main companies are there. Uske alawa hai nahi. Telecommunication is a short market with few firms. So here what happens, guys, this similar services provide karte hain, making marketing very homogeneous. Sab log call dete hain, sab log data dete hain, you know, all of the same services by all these companies are very much similar. So consumers can actually easily switch from one to other. Jo sasta dega, consumer uske paas chala jayega, isn't it? We all think like that. So what are they saying? That firms independently set their prices for calling, for data, whatever. So what happens if one reduces the price, the other will follow. You remember guys, ek time tha, मेरे पास भी एयरटेल का यू नो सिम होता था, एंड दैट टाइम जियो केम इन, एंड जियो ने तो प्राइसेस बिल्कुल हिला डाले. एंड दैट टाइम आई फेल लाइक अ फूल, दैट व्हाई एम आई पेइंग 499 व्हेन आई कैन लाइक पे 299 फॉर द सेम थिंग. सो देन जियो ने जब कम किया, अब आज के डेट में यू सी एयरटेल, जियो, सबके प्राइसेस सिमिलर हो चुके हैं. व्हाई? बिकॉज जियो ने आके मार्केट को बहुत चेंज कर दिया. सो बिकॉज ऑफ जियो हैड रिड्यूस द प्राइस, Airtel and everything, all the other companies, they had to follow. So because they kept on undercutting the price, क्योंकि सब लोग नहीं तो जियो के पास ही चले जाएंगे. नहीं मैं भाई उस टाइम पर सबके पास एक जियो का सिम था जब वो फ्री में मिल रहा था. Like on my phone, I literally have everyone's name, this Jio, one number and Jio. तो ऐसा था एक टाइम ऐसा, if you remember. So consumers are aware, consumers are not stupid. They will go to the company to get, you know, they will go to company जिसकी सबसे lowest cost है. And companies' pricing strategies ऐसा करेंगी so that more and more customers are coming to them. Of course, they will keep on undercutting prices. For example, if Jio ने 299 निकाल दिया, Airtel 298 निकाल देगी, वो और 297 निकाल देगा. So they all keep competing with each other by undercutting each other's price. Okay, and this is how like consumers क्या करते हैं? Consumers जो lowest देगा, उसके पास भाग जाते हैं. So basically, guys, after all that what I taught you, we reached to a game theory equilibrium, which is known as the Bertrand-Nash equilibrium. अब ये क्या होता है, guys? You will ask me. Basically, ये वो point है where P, that is price, is equal to MC, which is marginal cost. So as I told you, 298, 297, 296, ऐसे करते करते ऐसा तो नहीं हो सकता that they will, you know, give at a cost which is even lower than their actual cost. तो मतलब कंज्यूमर को उससे कम में तो दे नहीं सकते जितने में उनको पड़ेगा, राइट? सो दे हैव टू हैव अ लिमिट कि इसके इससे नीचे प्राइस नहीं हो सकता. सो दैट इज बेसिकली द एमसी, दैट इज द मार्जिनल कॉस्ट. मार्जिनल कॉस्ट के नीचे गए तो लॉस में आएगा. नो कंपनी वुड लाइक टू प्रोड्यूस एट अ लॉस. सो एनी डिविएशन फ्रॉम दिस प्राइस वुड एक्चुअली रिजल्ट इन अ लॉस ऑफ मार्केट शेयर. क्योंकि कंज्यूमर्स क्या करेंगे, लोअर फर्म के पास चले जाएंगे जो सस्ता दे रहा है, और उस फर्म को क्या होगा, उस फर्म को बेसिकली लोअर प्रॉफिट हो जाएगा, इनफैक्ट लॉस हो जाएगा अगर इससे भी नीचे गए. So what happens eventually in the long runs, firms actually earn zero or no economic profit. And we produce at P is equal to MC, जो actually perfectly competitive market में होता है. Though this is an oligopoly, but because of price war and all of this, we actually reach to a point where we actually produce just a perfect competitive market पे होता है, P is equal to MC पे. And companies of course reach to the most efficient outcome because of this model. So lastly guys, let's come quickly to the diagram. So over here we have a diagram where both the firms A and P are our producers. We notice the reaction firms in blue and red. So we notice guys, A and B both set the lowest price. If A ka price kam hai, obviously people A se khareedenge. Agar B ka price kam hai, then people B se lenge. Both don't want to set lower than MC. Agar lower than MC hoga or marginal cost se, so obviously loss hoga. So what are they saying? Best is to produce at this point where both are intersecting, that is the point E, equilibrium point है. ये point क्या है, जिन दोनों के firms का price is equal to marginal cost at this particular point. So obviously they are saying if A क्या करेगा, MC से higher price रखेगा, B undercut कर लेगा and obviously take away both the all its customers in fact. So eventually क्या होगा, MC पे reach कर जाएंगे. So this is what Bertrand's model is. Because of intense rivalry, we have price is equal to marginal cost, and we notice that there are zero economic profits in the long run, and producers work on the most efficient outcome. So this is all about the Bertrand's model, guys. Let me quickly run through the differences in the three models. So Stackelberg model, as I told you, is a first mover advantage. Cournot model is based on quantity setters, whereas Bertrand's model is based on price setters. Here we are arguing in price, there we were arguing in quantity. One more difference is that in Cournot, both the firms share the market, but in Bertrand's, jiska low price hai, wo puri market le ja sakta hai. So this is all about these three models, guys. I hope you are super duper clear with all the three models, and thank you so much for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next video pretty soon.